As members filed in, the final event at the Chamber of Commerce ahead of the general election got underway. The majority of the electorate will have key issues that they'll be thinking about when they cast their votes, and the business community in the Falkland Islands is no different.
I suppose the ability to trust MLAs to take balanced decisions, really, not to be influenced by where the heart goes, but more common sense, really, and actually analysing the situation. We've had some pretty poor decisions made, in my view, particularly for the long-term prosperity of the islands from the previous government. So I'd like to see a little bit more consideration and thought gone into some decision making. Stability obviously is always crucially important to businesses, but what's really important to all businesses is that we have a functional government. We have a government that provides an awful lot of goods and services that we all rely on. Some of them are more dysfunctional than others, but I think what I'd like to see in the next 4 years is a real concentration on the administration of government and its efficiency.
I never vote on personal opinion. I always vote on what they're standing for, and I like to hold them to it. So, yeah, this is not a popularity contest for me. I just vote for the candidates that I think are going to do the best job to help my business and, of course, develop the Falklands, because I've got grandchildren here. So, you know, somebody that's keyed towards education is always key for my vote. But I think they all want the same portfolio this time round, which is going to be a bit difficult.
With a membership of over 100, the Chamber of Commerce is highly representative of the private sector. And as campaigning began, they hosted a series of events allowing members to question candidates.
We put out our priorities list for candidates to consider before the election. We've had the opportunity to discuss those. Frankly, I think some of the candidates didn't quite understand some of the issues, and that's revealing in itself. But, you know, it's a democratic process. We talk to everybody. We get to understand who thinks what, and more importantly, how they will react as a candidate is not necessarily what you think. It's about how you will interact, how you will interface with the business community that really matters. And so people will make up their minds on that basis.
Whether the hopes of the business community will come through on election night, we'll shortly find out.